Let's go. Smoking on that smoke, smoke. We smoking on that smoke, smoke. Smoking on that fire, baby. Smoke, smoke. Smoking on that smoke, smoke. Smoking on that smoke. We be smoking on that fire, baby.
California reparations panels approve payments of $1.2 million for every black resident.
$1.2 million?
$1.2 million.
Shit, you know you come with some restrictions, nigga, and some motherfucking guidelines, nigga.
What, can't go to the jewelry store?
No, that would be good when you can't buy no shoes, you gotta buy property, nigga, and motherfucking, you gotta invest that shit, bro.
Oh, that'd be hard.
That would be hard, nigga.
You gotta have responsible reparations.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. But your stipulations are, I think your ancestors have to be some type of slavery type shit. Yeah, your ancestors.
Wait, hold on. So we all gotta go to.
Hold on, yeah. Oh, shit. Cali and West Show, nigga. Cali and West Show. What's going on, y'all?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, man, like some type of shit like that. With slavery, you gotta have some type of lineage of slavery.
Wait, hold on. Before we go there, bro.
Oh yeah, welcome to the motherfucking Cali and West Show, nigga.
Yeah, what's going on, nigga? Yeah, it's another day, man, on the island.
Another day, another dollar to make a holler. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man.
Tell everybody who you is.
Oh, man. Shit. They want to know who I am. Y'all want to know who I am?
We're doing the Cali and West Show.
Nigga, we can cuss. Nigga, we can get it cracking and all that shit. Nigga, you know what I'm
Hopefully
saying?
Hopefully, y'all already got your glass filled up with something nice.
Yeah. But yeah, that's the thing, though. But $1.2 million, that ain't really a lot after taxes. Because all that shit going to be taxed. Y'all know that shit going to be taxed.
$750,000.
Yeah, 758. Yep. Gonna be taxed and shit, and you know you get a little bit back at the end of the year, but yeah. So yeah, well, for those of y'all that know, yeah, we was having a conversation and shit, man. You know what I'm saying? For those of y'all that don't know, I'm your boy Cali Slim, aka the Young Pimp, aka the Black D Martin, aka OG motherfucking Ratchet Domino nigga, and we out this bitch. But I'm still here, bitch. Go get my money, so then we can leave for real.
I love it. Shit, man. I'm your boy Wes Mack, and what's happening?
What's happening now?
The Barhead Late Night Assassin.
Assassinated.
While your haters over there knocking at your girl door.
What you doing, nickel?
I'm in the back knocking her down like bowling pins. Believe that. Let's start the show, Cali.
Get it started.
Let's do it.
Who's the sponsor?
Emilio's.
Who?
Emilio's.
Emilio's!
Emilio's Beverage Warehouse.
Where they at?
The 91 Freeway in Lakewood Boulevard.
91, bitches.
Over there, y'all.
Yeah, you know where you need to be at. Yeah, it ain't no under the table, bitch. You need to be
right
on camera.
Here,
Full display, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, and shout out to Mr. OG. You know what I'm saying? Y'all know what it is,
y'all
Mr.
Y'all
OG.
Get y'all
got that reflector
y'all
gotta
smoke.
Shit.
Y'all got to smoke great.
You know what I'm saying? Go follow him on Instagram. That's one of the sponsors of the show for that fire-ass motherfucking weed, nigga.
Woo! Top shelf.
Mr. OG. Mr. OG underscore farms, all right? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Or, what is it? Or Mr. Dot OG Genetics.
OG.
You know what I'm saying?
He on some scientific shit.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Mr. OG, man. And good looking out on all the bud and all the pounds and QPs and ounces and all of that shit. You bless us with, nigga.
Thank you. You know we smoking extraordinary because we don't do nothing ordinary.
Right, man. And another plug. Always and forever. Woo! Dami Mas.
Y'all see these bottles right here?
Man, $1,000.
Go get one.
$1,000.
Seen it first, right here.
$1,000. Line this motherfucker up, you know what I'm saying? Get him a little closer and shit. You know what I'm saying? $1,000, man. Dami Mas Tequila, man. Shout out to them, man. You know what I'm saying? That's one of the original plugs, man. Yeah. They've been fucking with us since day one, man. You know what I'm saying?
From the Ruta to the Tuba.
That's the B.B. Simon edition. Y'all know y'all be wearing the belts. Ball players,
yep.
You know what I'm saying? Rappers and all that shit. Y'all be wearing the belts. Some of y'all kids and shit be wearing the belts. Mm-hmm. That's what it is. That's the B.B. Simon.
Should we show them what the original one look like?
Yeah, show them the original.
So you know what I'm saying. This is the original one right here. It's the OG.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Classic.
Still pretty.
Classic.
Still pretty. You know
what I'm saying?
Still
but,
pretty.
You know, when you out here and you want to make that statement.
What they say, like the Rose Bowl, the granddaddy of them all.
You got to make that statement. It's that showstopper bottle right
there. Yeah, man. But I did have something I wanted to get into, bro. So we're going to get right into this shit, man.
Okay.
Ain't no motherfucking commercials and
that
shit, man.
What we waiting for?
So, Sexy Red. That's one of the, that's a St. Louis rapper.
Sexy
she,
Red.
Yeah, she's from St. Louis, okay. Man.
I like that.
She reveals some of the wild names for her new lip gloss brand, bro.
Really?
This bitch wild,
what,
bro.
What, she got some, like, freaky fruit flavors or some delicious, like, candy flavors or something?
I'm going to let you go ahead and check this out, bro. Check this out.
I got a lip gloss brand, and the names for my lip gloss is something that nobody would have ever thought of. I got one called Nut, and it's the color of some nut. I got one called Gonorrhea. It's green, like gonorrhea. I got one called Yellow Discharge, like how girls be having yellow discharge.
Very, very interesting.
Hole Pink, Booty Hole Brown, Coochie Juice. Oh, and Coochie Juice is pure with silver glitter. It's cute, like...
Wow.
Shout out to Sexy Red.
Wow.
Should her name be Sexy Red or like Clinic? Little Clinic.
Little Clinic Red. Clinic Red. Like, man.
Like, period Red.
This bitch said gonorrhea.
Nut. She said she had a nut colored lip gloss.
Is it nut flavored, bitch? Like, what the? Booty Hole Brown? What'd she say? Dookie Brown?
Yellow Discharge.
Oh, my God.
Now I want to know. I know yellow discharge may be something that women go through from time to time.
Right.
But is it the same color on every woman? Like,
I don't know. She said yellow discharge, so obviously she has some type of expertise in
the discharge color.
In discharge, like I don't know, man. She kind of ratchet like Big Glorilla, Like, that's like she that, like that's, what's that gutter or
that's
what
that's gutter.
That's gutter.
Gutter. Not gutter. You're not gutter.
Nah, gutter.
Gutter.
Ain't no ER
you're
on that
gutter,
shit.
Babe. You're
that's G-U-T-T-A. Hey. Gutter.
Yeah, you're a gutter,
you know what
babe.
So, gutter baby.
Now.
Gutter bay. Gutter baby. Man, sexy
discharge.
Red.
Discharge.
Yeah.
Discharge. She said she had nut colored lip. No,
nut
orgasm colored.
No,
Pussy juice.
Now, that might be the only one a nigga interested in getting for his bitch. You know what I'm saying? Getting for his girl.
It was clear with a little bit of silver. Now, that's probably a little accurate.
A little accurate?
A little pussy juice in my face from time to time and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Ain't nothing wrong with it, but yeah. Damn, though. Like yellow, that's wild.
Yellow discharge.
Gonorrhea.
Is yellow discharge like a loogie? Is it
that's
like,
the same color.
Like the shit that
that's
you
the
have
same
in
color
your chest?
When you got the flu. Like, you know what I'm saying? When you got a cold, a common cold, and the flu, like...
A discharge? Yeah. Is it discharge? That means...
Everything about her screams out St. Louis Clinic.
She might be a nurse at the clinic.
She might be a nurse.
Not a nurse. She might be the receptionist.
She might be cool with the nurse because she done seen them, like, so goddamn often. Like, shit. Like, that's crazy, bro. Are y'all women out here fucking with this shit?
Now,
like, what are y'all doing?
Y'all ladies out here, we checked her file, we checked her little profile, and she popping out here. A lot of women with her, a lot of people fucking with her.
She got about 800,000 followers, so they following.
Who's wearing the lip gloss?
Who wearing gonorrhea?
Who's wearing discharge?
Who wearing Dookie Brown? Booty Hole Brown? I thought booty holes was fucking, like, I didn't, booty holes is,
booty
I
guess, hole?
Well, some booty holes is hairy.
Well, the outside booty hole, oh. She didn't say nigga.
I just said some chicks got a couple peach fuzz around their booty.
Okay,
I don't
know.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, like, right?
Yeah.
I thought booty hole. That's what we thought booty holes was like, pink or red.
She
but
said
I guess that's
booty hole pink.
She said booty hole brown.
Oh, I thought she said booty hole.
So I guess that's after you done ravaged it. It turns into booty hole pink or booty hole red.
Oh god.
Once it opens up. You know how you doing the porno shots, you fuck the shit out the booty hole, you pull back and shit, you're like, ooh. Well, we're gonna open up and it's red and pink on the inside type shit. Yeah, man.
I'm still stuck on yellow discharge. And what is nut colored lip gloss look like?
I'm assuming I think she said clear or white or some shit like that, I guess. I don't know. She obviously has like a degree in this.
She has a
like, you know what I'm saying? She got a lot of experience, a lot of a degree. She got a bachelor or a master's or a PhD.
She's her own teacher, obviously. That's a professor.
That's crazy, bro. That's crazy as fuck, man.
You a nasty little mom. You a nasty little chick right there, man.
Would you fuck with her?
I like little brown skin things.
Would you fuck her or would you fuck with her?
I will fuck the shit out of her.
That's about it.
I don't. Because I'm pretty sure after a while we'll be talking this shit. She going to get on my nerves.
Who would you rather fuck, her or Glorilla?
Her.
Her?
Her. I don't even... I seen,
like, Lorilla done said she wear like the same drawers and shit like three. I don't know, some shit 3 days in a row or some shit. Like, I don't know.
I like a little chick with a little bit of meat on her. You know what I'm saying? A little bit of weight on them things. I know she thinks she thick. I know she thinks she thick as fuck. I know that, and that's her word. That's one of her quotes.
Right.
She thick as fuck.
Okay.
I need a little something else.
Let's get into the next topic real quick, bro. And then we'll go to a commercial after this. So let's get into Chris Brown, crazy ass, man.
Oh, my nigga.
Dude, okay. Chris Brown, man. I don't know what's going on with Chris Brown.
What do you
Brown,
do, man? What
Chris,
do you do?
It says, Chris Brown and crew reportedly involved in a physical altercation with Usher doing skate party in Las Vegas. That was Chris Brown's birthday party.
Oh, okay.
All right, so I'm going to roll some of this footage, man. Check this out.
Man,
what's going on, man?
I thought, ain't he on tour? What's going on?
Shit, he supposedly on Usher tour. That's what I'm saying, bro. And I'm just like, out of all of this shit, this nigga was calling her all type of bitches and shit. See? Bitch this, bitch that. Where the fuck is Iman Shumpert?
Where's her dude at? Where's her man at?
Because that's his wife.
Oh, yeah.
Where the fuck is Iman Shumpert?
Oh, he gonna have, hey Chris, you gonna have to check in with Iman about that right there, bro.
He like on bloods, nigga. I ain't gotta tap in with no nigga. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Iman
on
Shumpert. I don't think he worried about that. Chris, he wanna keep the homies with him all the time.
Right. Yeah, Iman Shumpert 6'5", nigga. Got that long reach, nigga.
He got them big lips, like he just like he like getting punched in his face and shit. Got a long time of getting punched, so you know.
Yeah, yeah. I don't understand it, bro. Just Chris Brown gonna run into the wrong crew. You know what I'm saying? And from what?
Any R&B?
Yeah, R&B.
Your R&B dudes was like, Tim, y'all was caring. Y'all had rainbows and shit.
Love.
With flowers.
Love and shit. Dancing to a bitch with the boombox and shit in the rain and shit.
You ain't gonna get no bitches like that, Chris. I know you got the bitches already, but you ain't gonna get them like that.
Nah, man, and you kind of, especially when you doing that to Usher. Usher's supposed to be like, that's his what? That's
your
like,
OG.
That's your that's OG. Like your R&B OG. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Definitely. Like you supposed to like, and you know, bro, on some cool shit, man. And you like, you don't get no brownie points. You don't get no cool points for that shit, bro. You then supposedly they went around after they left. They went around the tour bus and shit, and supposedly either he swung on Usher or the crew ended up, you know what I'm saying,
yeah,
getting on Usher and punching
Usher
him and shit.
Came back with a little bloody nose or something.
So, yeah, bro, like, you don't get no cool points for that, nigga. Like, Usher don't bang. He ain't about that life, nigga. He about singing to the bitches. You know what I'm saying?
But,
like, come on, bro.
But why you getting mad at the bitch, though?
Where is Iman Shumpert?
Hey, man.
Like, nigga.
Hey, he probably thought, hey, baby, you going with the R&B crew?
You going to be cool.
You good. You good. Yeah.
So what do? You see Iman Shumpert, and you see this shit on TMZ, Shade Room, Say Cheese, No Jumper, and all of this shit.
Yeah.
What's your next move?
I'm pulling up to the next concert.
You ain't hopping on no phones, no nothing, bro.
Pulling up. The next concert.
Pull up.
You got bread enough to hop backstage, get that backstage pass, be back there backstage right before you about to go out.
And your homeboy should understand and move to the side, like, bro. This ain't this. You cussing at his wife, bro. Yeah, like, this ain't his girl and shit, bro. You cussing at his wife.
Side,
that nigga took an oath with the girl. You know what I'm saying? With Tiana Taylor, nigga.
Def dude was part.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, bro. Like, yeah, he definitely got to pull up, like you said, bro. That's some bullshit, bro. Yeah. Come on, Chris. Like, man, like, you got to do better, bro. We fuck with you, man. We fuck with your music and everything, man, and all of that shit, bro. Like,
what's
on some cool
issue?
Shit. Like, yeah,
what's
bro. Like, drugs, nigga.
Don't put that on.
What you mean? Like, it's a well-known fact that He indulges in drugs.
I mean, some weed, some liquor.
Mixed with some perks and some cocaine and some Xanax, maybe? Like, shit, I don't know. But okay,
well, if you're living life like that, man, you need somebody to pull up on you and tell you, hey, bro, you tripping. That's the thing about it. If you're living life like that, don't be ashamed when somebody pull up on you that fuck with you and say, hey, bro,
that's what the homies, we're not talking about Usher. That's what the homies should have did. The homies right there on the spot. Like, if y'all, like, the homies got to be real men in that situation. Be like, hey, bro, that's the female, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, just calm down, bro.
Just go skate it off,
bro. And then the fact that y'all niggas teed off on Usher, bro, like, come on, my nigga. Y'all don't get no cool points for that. I know we keep it West Coast and shit and all of that shit, bro, man. But, like, just on some gang shit, nigga, like, y'all know where the ops at. Y'all know where the enemigos at and all of that shit.
Right.
Pull up on them niggas.
Right.
Usher, nigga? nigga. Usher, really, nigga? Really, nigga? Like, come on, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's like the king of R&B, nigga. Like, hey. King of R&B.
And his Vegas live concert.
You ain't invited to Diddy's next white party, Chris Brown. Oh, white party. You ain't invited, nigga.
See, we gonna be there.
Because you can't bring the homies. And the thing is, I heard that the nigga got a squabble. Like, that's the thing. Like, bro, like,
so come on. I need to figure out more, man. Was it a fade? Was it a jump in? I need to figure out more on this altercation. Who got the tape?
Well, and we trying to figure out what was the issue with Teyana Taylor, bro. Like, you don't turn up on no female like that, bro. Like, you just don't do it. You just don't do it.
What was your motivation for it?
That's what was the motto, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's it, bro.
But, you know, playing devil's advocate to the situation, not knowing what was said to him by her, she may have been on some reckless shit. She may have been on some, like, I'm feeling myself. Like, nigga, that's why Usher better than you, nigga, and your life.
What'd you say, nigga? She stole one of the niggas.
She may have stole one of his nigga dance moves.
And was like, I don't give a fuck, nigga. Like, fuck your dance move, nigga.
It's my shit now.
You know what I'm saying? Like, all of that type of shit. Nah, man, but yeah. But shout out to Chris Brown, man. Come on, man. You got to do better, man. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Usher, man. On some man shit, you did your job, bro. Regardless of the consequences, you did your job as a man, mm-hmm. speaking up for any woman.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And shout out to Teyana Taylor. You know what I'm saying? Yep, no matter 100%. What a bitch say, if a female, unless a female be like, nigga, hit me, nigga. I want you to hit. Then, other than that, nigga, like, it ain't no point for that. You know what I'm saying? But shout out to everybody. We hope everybody can work it out, man. Right, you know what I'm saying?
Them three L's, man. Love, living life.
Love, living life, man. And on that note, we going to love living life, and we going to love running these motherfucking promotions because they making us money. We'll be right back after this. Mr. Breaker, bitch, back, turn your cameras on. Mr. Breaker, bitch, trapped like a bag of a phone. I keep my foot on her neck like the shadow was on. Mr. Breaker, bitch, back, turn your cameras on. Mr. Breaker, bitch, trapped. Mr. Breaker, bitch, child. Blame it on my truth, blame it on I let this bitch go. Blame it on the streets, blame it on my truth. Blame it on my gang, I let this bitch go. Oh, that shit banging right there, nigga. You know what I'm saying? That shit banging, nigga.
Hey, that could have been you.
Yeah, y'all don't know nothing about that, man. So let's hop into Krishan and Blueface again. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, they stay in the news.
Bro. They stay in the news, bro. So, apparently, Blueface's mama congratulates Krishan on the pregnancy, right?
Okay. But, shout out to moms for that.
But his mama said congratulations on being a nigga's second baby mama.
now, that's a little bit of shade on that shit.
That's some shade on it, right?
That's some shade on that shit. A whole cloudy day.
Man, what's going on with them, man?
What's nothing wrong with her being his baby mama?
No, but
what's wrong her being his second baby mama?
But apparently it's something wrong when he didn't want the baby to begin with. And then his mama probably didn't want her pregnant by him. He's like, you got Krishan pregnant? You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, one, man, you gotta do better than that. That bitch? What was it? That bitch? No.
Yeah.
That ain't it, bro.
But shit, you know what, moms don't have to be happy for it.
Nah.
What Blueface think?
Blueface don't want it from the beginning. When she first said she was pregnant, he like, I don't want it. Yeah, I ain't even a daddy. You got like probably like 7-8 potential baby daddies because I went through your DM.
Yeah, and
I
seen be clowning the bitch.
I seen it, bitch. I got you, bitch. You know what I'm saying?
He be clowning her.
He be clowning her, man.
But you did nut up in her, though.
Yeah, bro.
Hey, Blueface,
only you can prevent forest fire. I mean, only you can prevent pregnancy.
And that one way for sure is you can't get pregnant from swallow.
There you go.
I know she a gobbler.
Boom! Can't get pregnant from swallow. You know what I'm saying? So that's going to be a very toxic situation, bro. When that baby finally comes, man. I thought I've been seeing her drinking. I could be wrong. I thought I've been seeing her drinking on other podcasts.
We don't know when these podcasts have been filmed.
Okay.
But I have seen it. I don't think that was a very healthy wound.
Nah. Not at all.
B-U-T, she's a fighter. You know what I'm saying? She's a former athlete.
Right.
So she got the genetics to counteract some of that drinking and smoking.
And I know that she's calmed down on a lot of the fighting since she's kind of confirmed or announced that she was pregnant, which, you know what I'm saying, we commend you for that, because we know you like to turn up on any little fucking situation. Boom, 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 boom.
That's a level of growth that we can appreciate.
Yeah, definitely a level of growth. But like I said, Blueface don't want it. You got to keep a nigga baby. Ooh. You know what I'm saying? Wait, you was weak and pussy. Wait,
hold on. Don't do it like that.
I'm just saying, bro.
We don't hope that's a keep a nigga baby. That's his bitch. That's his chick. They kick it all on every.
But how much do you fuck with a bitch when the first thing out your mouth is, bitch, I don't want this baby?
Okay. Most dudes that say that, they be like, I don't want this baby, and they don't be on TV with her. Unless it's all about the publicity and the dollar line.
Business. Yes, there you go.
Business? Okay.
Business.
Well, she always on your lap. Business.
Because if that
always speaking up for you, business.
So the first thing, we'll tap into that later. We'll tap into that later. But yeah, man, like y'all get it together, man. Shout out to Krishan, man. Hopefully she can stay, you know what I'm saying, healthy during the whole pregnancy and everything like that, man.
And I hope that y'all get y'all situation together, man. Please keep your hands off each other unless you're smacking that ass from the back.
Just don't marry her, Blueface. That's all I'm saying. Be a good daddy to the baby. Just don't marry her, man.
Oh, marry her. Marriage.
Don't do it. You're setting yourself up for failure, player.
He ain't gonna do it. He ain't gonna do it unless the TV show pay for it. And shout out to getting your money.
Yeah.
Sign that prenup.
Yeah, man. I don't know, bro. That's some crazy shit, though, man. Your mama. We just talked about that. If your mama don't like you, bitch.
That's a problem.
That's a problem.
That's a problem.
That's a problem. But if your mama.
Her daddy don't like that nigga.
Well, he knocked her daddy out.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? So the likings don't go both ways. But all that matter is that we can tolerate each other. Bobby and Whitney, people didn't like them together.
Nope.
They wasn't good for each other. Just toxic.
And everybody but get on Whitney.
They loved each other.
Who started that cocaine habit first? Like, who brought the cocaine habit to the relationship?
Man. Listen, man.
Who you think? We don't want to talk about nobody that's dead or passed away.
I don't know. I know Bobby Brown ever since he was New Edition. He always was energetic, so.
Every little step I take.
He didn't need no extra energy.
I need some cocaine every little step I take. I snort a line of. That's been New Edition. Everybody give it up a New Edition.
Don't do my nigga.
No, I fuck with Bobby Brown, nigga. You know I fuck with Bobby Brown, nigga.
I ain't gonna put no shit.
I fuck with Bobby Brown, tough.
On Whitney.
Tough, nigga.
But.
Nah. The dead can't,
but the Whitney
the dead can't speak for themselves, so we putting on Bobby. OG Bobby Johnson. Mm-hmm. Bobby Brown. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, nigga. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, man.
Hey.
But yeah, man.
That's a toxic relationship that worked out. So
is it working out or
Bobby and Whitney? They was happy.
Oh, okay. Oh, they was happy there. So what was this on there? We belong together. Some shit, nigga. They came out a single and shit and all that shit, nigga. We got something in common. crack cocaine. We got in common.
You going real hard today. You going real hard today.
Hey, man, I'm just saying, man.
I don't know why you going so hard today.
Nah, we going to change topics, man. So we going to talk about Big Snoop.
Big Snoop Dogg.
Big Snoop Dogg,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
So apparently.
LBC.
LBC, man. He done made himself into a legend, man. So word has it that Snoop Dogg joined entrepreneur Nico Sparks in a bid to buy the NHL's Ottawa Senators.
Oh, big boss moves.
Now, they
living the boss's life.
Yeah, but they're in a bidding war.
Who?
Against Ryan Reynolds.
Ryan Reynolds.
That's
from Deadpool.
Deadpool. Yeah. In a bidding war with Deadpool.
I like that nigga too. I like
to buy that team. So what you think about Big Snoop, OG Snoop? You know what I'm saying, Crippin' Snoop. What you think about him?
One of the most famous Crips around the world.
The most famous Crip around the world, nigga.
You know,
what you think?
I love that move. That was outside of the box.
Oh, like, that's way outside the box.
Ain't nobody thinking about Snoop in hockey. BUT, he's bringing it back to the essence.
Now
he started this shit.
Now he done DJed a couple of hockey games.
Yeah. We started this hockey shit.
Well, no, we didn't start it. We gonna finish it, nigga. He probably gonna bring the niggas. To hockey, nigga.
We're riding the footage, man. They got a hockey team back in the in the 1800s.
What said the entertainer say? You know what I'm saying? That's when you know shit done changed. You guys got bros out there, nigga, just sliding and shit.
Ooh, can't hit
Come
me.
On, you're supposed to go can't with me, nigga. You're supposed to go with me, nigga. Just slide, nigga. You know what I'm saying? On ice, nigga. They ain't got no hockey stick, no gloves or nothing, nigga.
Just looking for fades.
Cause I wish a nigga would, nigga.
You know okay, you don't want no problems?
Wish right. a nigga would, right. You know what I'm saying?
Like,
but that is dope, though, bro. Like tapping into hockey, bro. Like hockey's actually cool.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? It ain't nothing but ice skating and fights.
That's it.
And niggas don't like ice skating. The one thing niggas do like,
they like fights.
You know what I'm saying?
They like fights like and scoring.
Fights and scoring. You know
like
what I'm saying?
Fights and scoring.
So I think that's a match made in heaven. Bring more awareness to the NHL.
Come on, man. Bring a different type of awareness. Yeah. Now, that's just one thing, bringing awareness, like you take it to another country, like hey, trying to bring awareness. But when you can bring a whole different crowd to this stadium.
That's the one thing the NHL is missing, is the hip-hop crowd.
That hip-hop crowd.
They missing that mm-hmm. that 18 to like 35 black, Hispanic, black, brown.
That don't know about it, but real interested in it.
Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. So and that's what it's missing, bro. Man. You know what I'm saying? What the fuck is you doing up in Canada, nigga? You know what I'm saying? Hey, let me find out Canada got more fireweed than California, you know what I'm saying? Or Colorado and shit, or Oregon, you know? Or Washington. Hey, let Snoop, me find out, nigga.
Hey, Snoop, tap in with us, man. Let us know what's going on, man.
Yeah, for real, shit, bro. For real, OG.
You should get it, though, man.
Yeah.
I think that...
Shout out to
that
Snoop.
If they're thinking outside the box and want to bring a new energy, a new culture to their stadium, come on, man. That's the way to go right there. Because he has a big, big following.
Yeah, he sure do, man.
I definitely want to go to a hockey game.
Snoop got some Canadian bitches up there, man. I don't know what Snoop doing up there. I don't know what you up there doing, Snoop, but you're cooking. You know what I'm saying? You up there, you're cooking some shit up. You know what I'm saying?
I wonder, is he coming with pounds? Like, look here, man. I can offer you this. And I got all these people.
Snoop ain't got enough pounds. Well, no, you might have enough pounds to buy a motherfucking hockey team. There ain't no pounds in the world to buy a motherfucking NBA team or NHL team or baseball. I mean, NBA team, MLB team, or NFL team.
Hold up, you got to start somewhere.
We need to call Rallo because Rallo got caught. Or call Corvain Cooper because them niggas is the plugs, nigga. Them niggas is 100 tons, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Uncle Snoop, man. Like,
Snoop
yeah, that's a big boss move. Yeah, bro. That's a whole different look, bro. That's a whole big different look, man.
I can see Snoop Dogg in a big old, big ass fucking hockey jersey.
Yeah.
And sagging off his ass.
Yeah, I know, right? With a big blunt in his mouth and shit. You know what I'm saying?
That's cool.
I got some other shit, man.
What you got for us?
So, let's get into... Speaking of buying shit, you got Shaq, Kenya Barris, and 50 Cent all teaming up to try to buy BET. Yes.
BET?
Yes.
Is that right?
Your 50 Cent said, green light, gang. You know I don't miss. Let's play. Let's make a deal.
Ooh.
Hey, man.
See, 50, you out here making these power moves, man.
Yeah.
You know, everybody I know except for my brother. Everybody I know watch your whole series, man. From the Powers, from the one with Tommy, from the Power Book,
Ghost, and all of them niggas. Man, yeah,
50, you ain't missing, man.
BMFs,
man. Like 50, I
say y'all buy BET and start showing that shit on BET Plus, nigga. That's what I say, nigga. You know what I'm saying? That's what I say, nigga.
Whoa.
That's a big fucking move, bro. Bring BET back to the essence, because right now, Viacom own these niggas. That's MTV for you stupid niggas out there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And it ain't the same.
It ain't the same.
What happened to 106 and Park? What happened to Bow Wow? You know what I'm saying? What's the nigga name with the dreadlocks and
what
shit?
What happened to AJ?
AJ and Free. Oh, let that booty free. Amistad, let the booty be Amistad.
Let it flow.
Give the booty us
let
free.
Let it flow with the earth.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Y'all don't even remember that.
You know what I'm saying? But
bring back the cypher.
The cypher.
What was it? BET,
Oh, the basement.
The basement.
Ticking and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, when it was rapping, head up. When it was going at it.
Oh, that was the Freestyle Friday. The
Freestyle,
you know what
Friday.
I'm saying? Like, shout out, man. Bring all that shit back, man. You know what I'm saying? What happened to all that shit, man? Y'all let MTV take over. You know what I'm saying? Fuck all that.
Return
it to its rightful users. Return it to its rightful race. Return it to the people. Return it to us.
Cause I don't remember the last time I seen New Jack City up on there. What the New Jack City?
New Jack City on the other side. No, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
I don't remember the last time I seen Menace of Society.
Oh, they play that shit. No, USA. I think USA
played
that
BET,
shit.
BET though.
Yeah. See, return to the essence, man.
When last time you played Paid in Full, man?
Shaq, 50, and Kenya, buy that shit up, nigga.
Run it up.
You know what I'm saying?
Run it up and blow it up.
Blow it up, man.
Shit.
50 don't miss. Shaq don't miss. I don't know too much about Kenya Barris, his investments, but obviously if he's in on the deal, then he's one of them businessmen. That he's a mogul.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying? 50.
And when you do that, Shaq, when you do that,
bring Kanye West on BET. You know what I'm saying? Bring Kanye West on BET.
Give us our song. They ready for us. We'll be on the uncut.
Bring back the uncut.
The BET uncut.
The most famous video on uncut, nigga.
Tip drill, nigga.
That was it right there. I need a tip drill. So y'all can see a nigga dancing in there. My movements and shit now. Y'all niggas, y'all bitches now, nigga. Yeah, nigga, I got all that shit. But yeah, bring back all that shit. BET Uncut, Cali and West. The Cali and West show on Uncut. You know what I'm saying? We travel around the world. You know what I'm saying? Going to sip expensive motherfucking liquors and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Smoking the best weed in your city.
This ain't most expensive. This is Cali and West. Do America. We fuck America. You know what I'm saying? Bang, bang, bang.
World tour.
Nah. But yeah, man. Holla at us, man. But yeah, shout out to y'all, man. Do y'all shit, man. Hopefully y'all get it, man. Y'all gonna get it.
That's boss,
man. You know what I'm saying? Like Nipsey said, man. You know what I'm saying? Put positive energy in the atmosphere, man, and it'll appear. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to the movement, man. To the movement and growth in yourself and stepping outside of your lane.
Yeah.
Because everything that you want, if you can think about it, you can attain that shit.
Yeah.
Man. That's real shit, man.
If you can imagine it, it can happen, man.
Man, positive affirmations, man. That's what it is. And everybody out here, we see 50 Cent, we see Snoop Dogg making these moves, Shaq making these moves, Kenya making these moves, and shit. All y'all gotta do is take one step forward and make a move for yourself, man. And you can be your own Snoop Dogg, your own 50 Cent. Because your boy Cali and West, oh yeah, shit. We getting to it.
Yeah, man.
We getting to it.
Before we end the show, let's just tap in real quick to two things. One, Gillian Wallow are getting into it with Joe Budden.
Whoa! Shout out to Gillian Wallow.
Now I don't know nothing about Ho Buddies. You know what I'm saying?
I remember he had one song on this month. Oh, he had one song. That shit.
Pump me up. And right now, nigga, you're pumping yourself up to the wrong niggas. It ain't on no gangster shit, but it's just on some bro.
What happened? What was the conversation like?
So they've been going back and forth for a minute, and apparently, Joe Buddies. This nigga put up a picture behind Gilly headboard with a little window and said, nigga, your master bedroom got little baby windows, nigga type shit, like what?
Wait.
And then both of them
was in the room in the picture.
He was with his girl.
Oh, okay. Talking about wifey and shit.
Yeah. And then Gilly just said, nigga, holla at me when you start getting that motherfucking you start getting that advertisement money, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Big boss moves on
that. Big boss moves, nigga.
You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to say a lot. When you talking to a hater, you ain't got to say a whole lot. Like a
couple words, nigga.
Hit them with some facts.
Because they're not worth all of that. They're not even worth the energy, bro.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? Remember, yeah, you seen Gillian Wallow out there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, bro. We were in Vegas at the fight. You know what I'm saying?
All day, man. All fucking day, man. Shout out to Gillian Wallow, man.
Bro, stop fucking with them bitches and you would have gotten the picture, too.
And then Joe Buttons is known for it. That's what Gilly says. Stop hitting the bitches. You know, for pump me up, hitting bitches, nigga, and
smoking cigarette by the pack.
Well, okay, that would be it. Smoke cigarettes by the pack.
I mean,
I was just, they have, you know, we West Coast. Beats by the pound, nigga. You smoking packs of cigarettes by the carton, nigga.
You know what I'm saying? Nigga stressed out.
Nigga, I think if they was in jail, I think Gidley would have sold that nigga. Wallow been in there 20 years. Wallow would have sold that nigga, Joe Budden's nigga. Nigga, for a couple cartons of cigarettes, nigga.
Hey, little
smoker
Joe.
Smoker Joe, nigga. Hold Joe to smoker Joe.
Doing all little cigarette and shit.
Yeah, bro. Stop fucking with these niggas, bro. Like, y'all on two different levels, bro. Y'all both have successful platforms, but then you got here, and you got here. And right now, Joe Buttons, you are here.
Right, but look, when you're trying to get here, it's that clout chasing shit.
It's the clout chasing.
It's the shit you're trying to be relevant. You're trying to get a bump up. And when you got a dude up here arguing with a dude down here, the only person that benefit is the nigga down here. Because nobody talking about that nigga.
All right, last thing on the list before we end the show. Chaka Khan and Missy Elliott get inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Chaka Khan, I always wanted to grab her by her hair and just say, what's up, Chaka?
Chaka.
What's up, girl? What you want to do to me?
The fucked up thing is, why Chaka wasn't in the Hall of Fame to begin with? Y'all wait until 2023. What happened to 2013? What happened to 2003? What happened to 1993?
What happened?
What happened?
What's the criteria to get in the Hall of Fame? Wait, you said the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Sting is part of that. He's one of the chairs.
I think so.
But yeah, he was saying the criteria.
Yeah.
You got to have like 25 some years in the game. You got to have what? like a musical influence.
Chaka got 40 years in the game.
You got to have an influence that actually changes. Whoa,
don't you know, sweet thing.
Oh, my God. Boom,
boom. Don't you know you my everything? Y'all should have put her in right then, nigga. Right then, nigga. How you got a star on the Walk of Fame, but you ain't in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
Sometimes the haters gotta let you in. Sometimes the haters gotta be like, hey, man, y'all see me right here at the dope.
Bad thing is, what?
Chaka, come here, baby.
What Rufus at? Where the fuck Rufus at?
Ain't nobody worried about Rufus. Hey,
ain't nobody Rufus worried about is Rufus.
Not relevant in nobody's
ain't
life.
Nobody, where Rufus at? I was just saying, where Rufus man, at?
Rufus. No disrespect, well, a lot of it, but ain't nobody worried about no Rufus. Rufus.
Oh, Chaka on her own with this one.
It ain't nobody in the world.
Oh, the disrespect, nigga.
That name has been washed out of the English verbiage.
Rufus?
Rufus.
From the Rufus to the Tufus?
Hey, it's only
that's
a uncle,
crazy,
it's
bro.
Only an Uncle Rufus. It ain't no Daddy Rufus. It's just an Uncle Rufus.
Uncle Rufus.
He may got no kids.
But that's crazy, bro. Just how long it took for her to get into the Hall of Fame. I understand Missy. That's cool. Missy, that's about time. You know what I'm saying?
She's about on time.
Yeah, she's on time.
Now, Chaka, you.
It's past time.
Past time.
Should have been in 93.
Damn.
93.
Damn.
83. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, like, come on, man.
Damn,
like,
what the fuck is y'all doing right now? For a long time.
How many titties she got to show? How many times she got to do?
She got to come out and headline in the award show.
Killing it. 40 years. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, but shout out to y'all, man.
Definitely shout out, man.
You gave her flowers while she was still here.
Yes, man.
So I got to.
And we're going to end the show on that one, man. Thank y'all for tapping in, tuning in, man. These your boys with the hot trending topics, nigga. Any part of words for the people out there, man?
We on fire, man. Oh, yeah, them three L's, man.
What's that?
Lakers.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, shit. More importantly, man, out here in this time of age, three L's, man. Love, living life.
Definitely.
And all my players.
Mm-hmm.
If y'all doing that shit right,
okay.
I need y'all to grab that girl over there.
And maybe your girl too.
Your girl too, man. But tell her, baby, tonight, we ain't going to bust and we ain't going to fight.
What we going to do?
Tell her, baby, tonight all we're going to do is drink, smoke, and pop.
Let me get a little splash. There we go. All right. What? Drink, smoke, and what?
All we're going to do tonight, baby. Tell her, baby, all we're going to do tonight is drink, smoke, and pop.
Drink, smoke, and pop.
That's it. Come on, players.
And as I always say.
Don't be on no Chris Brown shit.
As I always say. Yeah, don't beat the bitches up. As I always say.
What you always say?
Gotta let these niggas know.
Don't tell me, bro. Tell them.
Always drink in moderation. No matter what you see Cali and West doing, drink your ass in moderation. And don't drink and drive, motherfuckers. Please. Well, I'll let y'all.
We out.
We gone.
Get your brother.
Get your black.
Yeah.
You already know what it is, nigga. Cali on the beat, smoke house, nigga. Let's go. Smoking on that smoke, smoke. We smoking on that smoke, smoke. Smoking on that fire, baby. Smoke, smoking on that smoke, smoke. Smoking on that smoke. We be smoking on that fire, baby. Smoking on that smoke, smoke. We smoking on that. Smoking on that fire, baby. Smoke, smoking on that smoke, smoke. Smoking on that smoke. We be smoking on that fire, baby. Cali bout to blaze up. You ain't knowing this. Smoking on that bubble kush, high up in the